Assalamualaikum everyone, welcome to UA code 127.0.0.1. Hope so all of you are well and doing good in your life. Guys, as you know, I'm working on Try Hack Me walkthrough, and in my last lecture I covered total 10 tasks from Linux Fundamental Part 2, and due to the shortage of time I did not complete the whole task of this room. But don't worry guys, today I will complete the remaining part. So let's start from task 11. Guys, as I am already open my Kali Linux machine and SSH to the target machine. Guys, I teach you in my previous video how you can actually SSH to a machine to connect it remotely. Hope so now you knows about how to SSH to a machine. And let's start from task 11. This challenge is pretty simple. The binary is checking to see if the environment variable test1234 exists, and if it is set equal to current user variable. What is the password? What is the password for Sahiba 3? So first of all, I'm gonna show you if variable is exist or not. Then for this purpose I will run print env command and then name of variable, that is test1234, and hit enter. Guys, you can see that this variable is actually exist, and the value of this variable is Sahiba 2. Now I should run this binary, that is by using dot slash Sahiba2 and hit enter. Now you can see the output of this command. When I run this binary, the output of this command is here. This will be the password for the third user. So now I should move to the third user by using switch command, switch user Sahiba3, and hit enter. Now the password of this user will be HAPPY happy noises, noises, and hit enter. Now guys, you can see that I'm here in user 3. Okay, so in task 11 I found the password for third user. Let's move on to task 12. In this task, we will learn about advanced file operation introduction. Much like Windows, file have a lot of complexity to them. Multiple different parameters have to be modified to allow certain user to read to a file, write to files, and execute certain files. This section will cover modifying these parameters. Guys, basically in this section, you will learn about how you can read, write, and execute permission of files, and how you can actually change the ownership of a file, and how you can actually change the group of a file. So let's move on task 13. Recall that ls has different flags that allow you to view information about different types of file. Guys, if I type here ls command, if I type here ls, you can see that all the content of root directory is here. If I type ls and then la, it will show all the hidden files. Students, basically this is the file name, this is the id of this file, this is the date by which this file is created, and this is the read, write, and execute attribute of this file. This is the username of this file, and this is the group of this file. Basically, today we are going to discuss about three attributes, that is this one, read, write, and execute attribute, user of file, and group of file. Okay, now if we want to change the group or a user of a file, then what should I do? In task 14, I will learn about how you can actually change the ownership of a file. So if I create a new file here, that is by using touch, and I'm gonna create a file that is today and hit enter. Now if I check the permission of this file by using permission and attributes of this file by using ls-la command, guys, you can see that today is created here, the read write and execution permission is here, the username of this file is here, the group of this file is here. Now if we want to change the user of this file, currently the user of this file is root. If I want to change the user of this file, I will type chown, then the new username, that is Kali, and then group of this file, that is root, and then name of this file, that is today, and hit enter. So guys, now if I check the attribute of all files by using ls-l command, now you can see that the user of this file changed from root to Kali. The rest of attribute remains same, as I did not change the group. So you can change the user of any file by using chown command. Now guys, if we want to change the group of this command, then what I should do? Firstly, I check all the groups available here by using cat etc group command and hit enter. Here you can see that all of these are groups present here. Okay, now let's change the group of today file by using chown command, chown, then user of this file, then new group name, that is Simon, and then file name, and hit enter. So now if we check the group of this file by using ls-la command, so guys, now the group of this file is changed from root to diamond. So in this way you can change the ownership of a file. In task 14 I covered about chown command. Okay, the question is that how would you change the owner of file to Paradox? Students, as I teach you earlier how you can basically change the ownership, chown command will be used, then the owner name of, and then file name, something like that. You can type chown, then owner name Paradox, and then file name, and if I hit enter, okay, there is a error because this user is not exist in this OS. So first I should make this user. To make user, I will use user add, I will use So guys, you can change the owner of a file to Paradox by using this command. What about the owner of a group to a file to Paradox? Now in this question, you have to tell about how you can actually change the group of a file. As I teach you earlier how you can change the group of file, chown command, then name of this, user of this file, and then group of this file, and then file name. So the correct answer will be here. What flag allows you to operate on every file in directory at once? Then the correct answer will be -r. -r actually will be used to operate on every file in directory at once. Let's move on task 15. Students, in this task you will learn about chmod command. Basically this command will be used to change the file permission. The syntax of this command is chmod permission and then file name. Here you can see that some digits and the meaning of these digits. If I type 1, it means that the file can be executed. 2 mean the file can be written. 3 mean file can be executed and written both, execute and write. 4 mean the file can be read only. 5th main the file can be read and execute as well. 6th main the file can be read and write and read both. And 7th main the file can be read, write and execute. Okay. If I want to change the file permission, something like that. If I type here ls and I have a file log.txt. If I type ls-la and check the permission of this file, you can see the permission of this file is read, write, read, read. Okay. Now if I type chmod and then I type 777 and then file name and hit enter. Now again I check the file permission by using ls-la. You can see that now the permission of the file is changed. That is read, write and execute. Read, write and execute. Because chmod 777 means the file can be read, write and execute. As you can see here, 7 means the file can be read, write and execute. So if I type here chmod and I type 455, I type 455 and hit enter. Now if I check the permission again, you can see that the permission now change read. As I type 4 mean read and then I type 5 mean the file can be read and execute. That is read and execute and execute as well. So in this way you can change the file permission. Okay, the question is that what permission mean the user can read file? 4 digits will be used to read. The group can read and write. 6 digits will be used for group and no one else can read, and 0 for no one else can mean to say 460 will be correct answer. Word permission means the user can read, write and execute. As you learned before, for write 7 digit will be used, for execute 7 digit will be used, and for read 7 digit will be used. So the correct answer will be 777. Okay, let's move on task 16. Students, in this task you will learn about rm remove command. If I type rm and then I type today and hit enter, it will remove the today file. Now if I check ls-la, here you can see that today file is disappeared. So rm command will be used to remove file. Word flag deletes every file in a directory. If we want to delete every file in a directory, word flag will be used. If I type main rm and hit enter, then you can see different flags of rm command. Here you can see that hyphen r will remove directories and their content. So the correct answer will be hyphen r. Hyphen r will delete every file from a directory. How would Now I want to move this file from desktop to Kali. I will type move the name of file and then destination and hit enter. Sorry if I type and hit enter. Okay guys, here you can see that on desktop I have a file, that is this. I want to move this file from desktop to Kali, so I type move command and then name of file and then destination with whole path. So now if I type ls, you can see that there is no file present on desktop as this file is moved to Kali. If I type cd dot dot and check the file is moved here or not, you can see that file 2 is now moved here. So move command will be used to move file from source to destination. How would you move file to temp? In this question, you can move a file to temp by using, if I type cd, then move, then file name and the destination where you can move it. Move file name and then destination is slash temp. The correct answer will be here. Okay, let's move on to task 18. Now that you have some intermediate knowledge to using Linux, finish Linux series and join the Linux Fundamental Room 3. So guys, in next video, I'm going to teach you about Linux Fundamental Room 3. Stay tuned and keep watching my video. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.